Hey everyone, it is Wednesday. You know what that means? That means we bring back Matt, the mortgage guy. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing all right. Well, topic number one of today is going to be your world has seen a, I don't know if it's too much to say, a cataclysmic shift. I believe personally the inflection point is in. I believe we have seen the low rate of the year. You've texted me a couple of times about, oh my God, they went up an eighth, went up an eighth of again. That was within a 6-day window. You know, to me, damn, that's a quarter, right? And that's, you know, that's a Fed rate hike. So just curious what's going on in your world. Maybe I'm overthinking it, but I'm guessing you're having a lot of conversations.
Right. And the thing of it is that mortgage rates change every single day. And I've talked at length with, you know, pretty much anybody who I come in contact with about that. But I'll generally have a conversation and say, hey, listen, it's going to fluctuate from day to day, but they're not huge fluctuations. That 2.625 might provide a $1,000 credit today, and tomorrow it's a 760 credit. And so like your rates aren't changing, but the discount or the cost for that rate might fluctuate a few hundred dollars. Well, when you have what happened over this past week, kind of starting last Wednesday on the 6th, mm-hmm. rates do shift, can shift rather dramatically. And so dramatic in our world is 2.65 to 2.875, or yeah. if you want to get more granular and people understand that every rate comes with either a credit or a cost, mm-hmm. that same rate, if we looked at what kind of move we saw, which was about 100 or 110 basis points, mm-hmm. if you're getting a $400,000 loan and 2.625 was free, no points being paid, mm-hmm. in a week, it went from being free to $4,000 or $4,400. So wow. that, you know, like last year when we saw that 50 basis point refi fee.
Yep.
Basically double that refi fee got implemented in the last week from the market. And something that I was looking at this morning, which is interesting, is the general public. Hopefully we can kind of simplify it for most people, but they think that certain stuff relates to other stuff where it doesn't, and they don't really have an understanding. Something that we should make clear is that the Fed funds rate being zero does not mean that mortgage rates cannot go up. And the thing that I was looking at earlier was from 2009 to 2016, we saw the Fed funds rate at zero during two different periods. I think end of 10, beginning of 11, rates went from 4 to 5 1/8. Went up over a full percentage point. Fed funds rate was still zero. Mm-hmm. So them not touching the funds rate had nothing to do with other market factors that can influence mortgage. And in 2013, when I was first getting started, I remember that summer and rates went from like 3.5 to 4.75. And, you know, that affects real estate market in a huge way. And because, you know, some people might think, oh, well, not as many people are going to refinance because rates go up, but the correlation between real estate demand for real estate and interest rates is huge. Another fun fact to point out is that when rates go up, the mortgage applications for the last week go crazy. You would think the opposite, but it takes the average bear a little bit of time, mm-hmm. because you know, they're going down like this and there's no sense of urgency, and then they start to tick up, and now all of a sudden my flood. Phone is ringing off the hook. Yeah. Hey Matt. And oh yeah, we showed you a scenario back on December 6th and you didn't act for 5 weeks. And now you're wondering, can we get that rate that we talked about on December 6th?
Yeah. I think there's a couple of things I want to point out. First and foremost, you're absolutely right. When rates start to tick up, especially if it's an inflection point, like I think we just had, you will get a flood of both buyers that have been waiting because they've been spoiled. For a year and a half, the longer they waited, the cheaper the rates got. They got spoiled. I think it's changed. Same with refis, right? They're like, I'm going to refi one more time, but I'm going to wait for the bottom. Well, you never pick the bottom. You never pick the top.
Right. Yeah. You can't go back and buy Tesla at
$40 share. Or whatever. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Wish we could. But that's interesting. And the other thing that I just want people to realize again is a pre-qual, pre-approval, and rate lock are all very different things, because you may have had a pre-approval at some interest rate, but until you have that little check mark of rate lock, you're at risk, at least some risk.
Right. Yeah. And on that subject, you know, even talking to a mortgage professional or seeing a quote, I can't just call the lender and say, hey, I've got a loan coming in 2 days. Go ahead and lock that person. We've got to have full application loan submitted to lock. We can't lock some future idea of some borrower that wants to get a loan done. One more thing I want to say, Mike, before I forget, because Barry Habib in the mortgage world is been spot on for 10 years. And the guy just knows mortgage-backed securities, everything that goes into it. He's got an interesting take. Mm-hmm. And I listened to his 2021 forecast, which he waited to put out because he wanted to see what happened with the runoff elections and all that. Mm-hmm. But his thought is that looking back, whenever debt increases, mortgage rates go down. So he's got an opposite view of you and a lot of folks in that he sees this little blip as just a little blip. But then as all this government stimulus and all this spending happens in 2021, he sees rates going down even further.
Wow. That'd be cool to watch. I love it. I love counter. So again, his idea is, and when you say debt, is that government debt or all consumer debt? Is it everybody debt or what's debt?
I think it's government debt. He's looked at, you know, not just US history, but sure, like France and other countries where, you know, as they spend and print money and basically create debt, mortgage interest rates go down. So, I mean, I'm with you where I've got one idea. Sometimes my ideas change. I'm open to everybody's point of view. And, you know, he's one that his opinion matters because he's a smart dude that's been paying attention to it for a long time. So it'll be interesting to see.
Yeah, that will be interesting. Because again, logically speaking, that makes sense, right? The government gets more debt and we got a whole bunch of stimulus coming, which equals more debt. They got to pay for it somehow. And it's easier to pay the cheaper the debt is, right? So you could see them getting really on that long end of the curve, right? And forcing rates down. The Treasury and the Fed could do that. Janet Yellen's coming in. So it could happen. I mean, could rates really get down to have a one on them? I mean, you want to see real estate explode higher. Go put a one on the 30-year mortgage.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. And it's funny too. This is the dangerous part about saying this is that, you know, folks who on the fence or waiting are going to be like, oh no, now I'm waiting. I mean, because I had conversation after conversation where if we don't go back, you know, I don't have a secret button or a secret alert that's like, okay, we're bottom. All right, guys, let's go. I probably had 15 to 20 conversations before all this though, telling people, listen, if it was me and I was in your spot, I would take it. I would not wait or any of that because we just don't know. Yeah. And now looking back, I'm glad. And I'm glad that I was straightforward with people saying, listen, it might get an eighth better, but based on everything I know, this is a refinance that makes all the sense in the world to you. I would do it if I was you. Yeah. And that's that.
Very cool. Well, any closing thoughts on this? Again, it's going to be interesting. It'll be interesting to see where rates go. And to me, again, if I had to pick one measure, I talk about it on my daily financial news all the time. I watch the 10-year treasury. That's going to be the thing I watch all year, right? Of all the metrics, unemployment and GDP and taxes, the one I'm watching the most is the 10-year treasury.
Yeah, for sure. And that's at 110 or something, I think.
Yeah, I think it was 118 at the beginning of the day. It's gone down a little bit today. It's like 112. But that's okay. What I'm watching. So, I mean, and it's
yeah. In closing, I will say for anybody watching, mortgagenewsdaily.com does a really good job. And if people want to kind of follow what the rate is doing, they take a rate survey. So it's not like my rates or Wells Fargo's rates or anybody else's rates. It's a survey of the broad landscape. And really part of the reason I like it is because it's a little bit higher than the rates that I can offer as a broker. But it at least gives you an idea of the trends, you know, and it will show you the day change and where things are going. Just keep in mind that when there's a published 30-year fixed, there's a lot of stuff that goes into that, you know, your credit score, your down payment, all that. So that's just a
And what was that survey. Site one more time?
MortgageNewsDaily.com.
Very cool, Matt. Well, thank you very much for this. I look forward to topic number two.